Morning. Okay, what we're doing, in case you haven't been following, 1960s, I made four teams: Packers, Bills, Giants, and Steelers. We're going through a connected franchise. Myself, this is my wife's account, by the way. Myself, John M., and two buddies. One can't join yet, so I'm operating the Packers through simulation. And excuse me, I'm waking up still. I'm playing the Bills. We have a new player, so we're on rookie level this season. Probably won't go above pro just because the goal is all pro can be tricky. We had a I had another connected franchise where out of nine players, only three made the playoffs and all pro. Some of it has to do with sliders, adjusting the new game and all that, but okay. We'll speed, slow, jump forward to the end of game, and that's how we simulate and launch. Just wanted to get my coffee before this started. Alright, so it's the 1960s Packers roster. The reason I'm controlling them through my wife's account is because we don't. The guy isn't ready to join yet. But, knowing that he is, I have to manage the roster. Never show me the weekly games. Green Bay won in week one against Seattle. Coming from behind, went 13-10, blocking a field goal on the last play of the game. I'm gonna do it back and we'll pour myself some coffee. Okay, sorry about the disappearance. Looks like Green Bay got a sack. Now these 1960s rosters in the file. I explained this before. There's only four teams that were done, the four that we're doing. And it's only going to be the first roster. I'm not going to go through and do every year off line, but I use Pro Football Reference to get the names, numbers, starters. And then I use Google to match the uniforms. Green Bay took a while for their offense to get moving last week. Atlanta blitzing. Bart Starr stand in the pocket and throw that pass. To match the 60s looks on both these teams, 1960 Green Bay, I used their 75th anniversary throwback helmets with the 1960s throwback away uniforms. And they did have away uniforms. Again, I've been complaining that some teams do, some teams don't. Atlanta, these particular uniforms were taken off the game this year. Had them last year, I wore them several times, but these were taken off. I had to piece this together using the 1970s home throwback with a 1990s home jersey. That's why the numbers are outlined instead of the way they were in the early Falcons history. Of course, there was no Atlanta Falcons in 1960. I just put them in these jerseys, the 66, I believe is when they came in. Just for the hell of it. Didn't have to, I guess, because they weren't around, but this is the second team the Packers have played that wasn't around. Well, we got an injury. It looks to be the guy that made the sack. And that'll bring Don Chandler on the punt. It's currently snowing quite a bit, too, here in upstate New York. And I woke up to help my wife, or make sure I didn't have to get out and snowblow or anything for my wife. It was clear her car was bare. I was at 3:30. It's now 7, quarter after 7, and there's quite a bit on the ground. Ooh, I'll be this too now. New England gets the 1-1-1, so the 1-1. Bears take out the Bucks, 32-15. Well, high score there. Oh my goodness, he's off. He's running. We just ran a 50-yard run against the Green Bay Packers defense. Oh, the Raiders destroying the New York Titans. I'm judging. Really, This is the only year that I have to use these helmets for Packers. They put the G on them in 61. You can download these rosters on PlayStation 4 by looking for Vinny X Wolf or 1960. Also, if you're a fan of the resims that I did, you may notice there's a couple videos where I basically canceled the program. Had an online vote that was getting zero attention. I'm doing, I'm still using this. The roster is made by I Teach History 78 for Madden 16. He's also got some for 17 18. He did a phenomenal job. I'm going to practice using the rosters. I'm going to redo any Bills and Falcons loss. Last night I lost as the Bills on All-Pro level to the Jets 17-3. Just to get some practice in. Sure looks like it said the Giants were 0-1. Kind of weird trick, though. Well, Paul Hornung with the spin moves, and he's off to the races. The Golden Boy, the former Heisman Trophy winner, is going to take that kickoff at the distance. 101 yards for Paul Hornung with a double spin. One spin, two spin, and he's gone. On my channel, this weekend, or next weekend, there won't be a 86 redo practice, though. It's alternate Super Bowl 9. You can follow along with more of that by joining Super Bowl of the Month Club. Back to the Madden Custom Rosters. The voting is currently on through Madden Custom Rosters group to see which other game gets redone. And that'll be tonight after Sunday Night Football. We get a tie game now, as Hornung then adds the extra point. Looks like something's eating away his helmet. What an explosive game so far. Taylor Gabriel making some moves. Yeah, I know some people say, oh, you should have done the whole league. Well, you'd still have teams like this, the Falcons and the Seahawks and the Panthers, that weren't around in 60. It's a lot of work to do one team. And with the other things I do, the ultimate Super Bowl and whatnot, I have a lot of work I do for these rosters to bring you these games. So, plus going into a connected franchise, or it's just going to be the four of us doing it. I have to control those four rosters every season now. I have to come in and tell the guys, listen, you could draft two running backs, six linebackers, and let me do my thing. You have to sign, we get the 90s. Green Bay, you got to sign a defensive end. And Reggie White in the free agent list. What a big play. This is definitely not 1960s football defense, that's for sure. The Super Sim goes a little faster than normal simulation. They tend to skip some of this in the in-between stuff, which is fine. It just took me by surprise last month when I was doing the Ultimate Super Bowl. I thought the one team was in no huddle, and they were not. See, I'm torn in this game because Atlanta's my NFC team. But Green Bay is the franchise we're following. I have a lot of mad respect for Green Bay anyway. I always said I kind of wish I was a Packer fan. I'm not. Don't get me wrong. I'm not going to always swim in debt with 13 world titles and clean on this line, which, by the way, is the number. For you Steeler fans out there, 6 is not the number. 6 may be great in the Super Bowl era, but 13 is the number of total world championships. throughout all the NFL. But anyway, like I was saying, when I was getting into picking teams as a kid, Green Bay wasn't that good, and you never saw them. So you only saw them in history books. Kind of like the Dallas Cowboys nowadays. That's a joke. I take shots at the team that won me. Dallas. Carolina. Miami. New York Jets. New England. Just because, you know, it's a football fan. That's what we do. I don't know what you'd call it. Probably some kind of neurosis. Claim that a team that has won 5 Super Bowls in 15 years sucks. It's not logical. But it's what we do. Right up the middle by Paul Hornung. First down. And that should do it for the first quarter. Atlanta leading 10-7. Big offense the first quarter. Alternate Super Bowl 9 will be next Sunday. It'll probably be late Saturday night or late Sunday night, one or the other. Los Angeles Rams and the Oakland Raiders. Raiders are missing the interception of 6. Ultimate Super Bowl and currently 1-4. Big pass play, touchdown to number 80. Steve Meilinger. And Bart Starr, 54 yards. We got another one. Freeman caught from behind. After 46 yard return. Caught by Jim Taylor. A lot of time from that one. The thing with the Giants game is confusing. He broadcast his week 1 game. You can watch it through this playlist that I've saved all the games in, or you can subscribe to his channel at John M. Go back and watch all those 86 games. It's crushing defeat in the Super Bowl for the Bills. He played the game. We all saw it. And we can see it. You can watch it. It's there. It's been registered that he played the game. After the Steelers finished, let's look at Vince Lombardi. We had to force advance. Because he's out of town right now. And it showed up that he wanted even better. 49-7 instead of whatever he'd want with. 55-20, I think. Now I quickly saw the record. It looked like he was 0-1. Tom Bettis. They won't make him stop. Huh. Out of the four teams, the Packers are the highest rated. They have kind of tons of Hall of Famers, plus maybe the NFL title in 1960. The Giants took a basic brief one-year hiatus from the NFL title. Making it in 58, 59, winning it in 56. Maybe winning in 57. 61, 62, and 63. 60 was the one year they didn't make it. So they're the second highest. And Pittsburgh's next, as they have a couple of Hall of Famers in Bobby Lane, Ernie Stotner, John Henry Johnson. And then Buffalo's the worst rated, as they have absolutely nothing and only a basic shell of what they would become. Lombardi and Mitch be trying to figure out what's wrong with the defense tonight. Oh, horning. Turned up. Side down. Star fakes the handoff this time. Flag down, but he completes the pass. I think it was Meilinger again.
Holding offense.
Island holding on Jim Ringo.
Still holding.
Star is getting sacked for Tack McKinley. Don Chandler on the punt. No, Chandler's with the Giants. That's Paul Hunting, maybe. Falcons have the lead in the ball. you. Good coffee this morning. Freeman stumbles and is finally brought down by Ray Nitschke. You can't, of course, really simulate fully. Nitschke coming in and making the sack. I do have one of my videos I talked about an idea they should do for 2019 for Madden 2020, the 100th anniversary of the NFL. And then just give us an option to go back and play the game, classic seasons, classic play style, classic rules. So if you were to want to do something like this, you'd go to pick Packers and go back 1960, and then up would come the NFL. Just the NFL, I mean, you'd be no AFL if you were playing the Packers, no Super Bowl. And you'd play that schedule. Your rosters would be obviously bland, like they used to put out. You'd go through and edit them yourselves. I'm sure there would be people out there that would go and edit the rosters, so you'd be able to download it. But you'd play that schedule, those rules. And you could either do it as a standalone or just pick that franchise and at the start. Say if you pick Green Bay, it'd be 1921. Even though, yes, they were founded in 1919, but you're only playing the NFL, so you can join the NFL for 21. There's weird things on these helmets, these classic Riddell lumbar helmets. So it looks like there's parts of the helmet missing. Swings it to Horning out of the backfield, and Horning, whoa, making moves and making men miss. Now the Packers in a hurry up. Bart Starr is only 2-3 passing. That's actually not unrealistic. They didn't throw that much. Packers are a heavy run offense, but I didn't input playbooks from the era. Star misfiring. 205, 75 yards, and a touch. Dallas getting their second. Bertino went winless in 1960. They're undefeated at 2-0. Starter back to pass. Goes out in the flat to Horning. And the Packers are moving. Yeah, it says the Giants are 0-1. That doesn't make any sense. Weird. Almost intercepted. Shot in the Oh, a diving catch. Made Lombardi happy. Cross to Max McGee. Star 5 of 10, 111 yards. That's the one thing they need to, I think EA Sports needs to improve on. The off-ball injuries. You can't tell who's hurt. It doesn't always tell you. And all of a sudden it pops up a minute later that your left tackle tore his shoulder or something. If it did say injury timeout, the Packers are down to one, so it might be a Packer. Did you get it in? It kind of looked like he turned the ball. And, well, second and goal, 15 seconds. They had a Pounds Horning right up the middle. They're not gonna because they run under 2017 rules. Stark could run it. No, he's gonna throw a touchdown to Max McGee. No. Yeah, Boyd Dowler. That looked more like Aaron Rodgers than Bart Starr. After all, it is Aaron Rodgers originally. On the stat sheet, it's half day. Starts. He has not thrown three touchdowns. Paul Hornung had a kick return. Well, there are issues with this. See? Three touchdowns. There are issues with the stats. When John M. and I did that one season where I was the 91 Bills and he was the 86 Giants, Bruce Smith had 28 sacks and didn't register in the leaderboard. You could see it in his own stats, but on the leaderboard it had Lawrence Taylor leading with like 22. Now they're giving the kick return credit to Bart Starr for throwing it. No, man. has 26 yards rushing. Oh, incomplete. Could not hit Gremlinger. I'm sorry. Number 80. Let me look it up real quick. One scored the second touchdown. My phone's being slow now. Meilinger. I don't know why my Steve Meilinger. Well, I just drew a blank on that, but the 30-year-old out of Kentucky. Ryan hits Mohamed Sanu. This issue with the Giants is just a one-time mix-up and screw-up that I didn't record his win correctly, and then when I force-simmed it and then they get the win again, it still didn't record it correctly. Because, I hate to see it go south like that. I will say this, it was all kinds of issues with week one. There was three different games that were coming up showing the scoreless ties. And they didn't end up that way, so maybe it was just a week one issue. As this week they're not showing any of that. Nice move by Freeman. John Simmons. Davis chasing down Freeman to make the tackle. That's his first tackle of the afternoon, according to the stats, which we've learned in this game, can't trust. Coleman on the carry. Greminger making the tackle. Coleman. No, yeah, Coleman with a second touchdown in the afternoon. Tevin Coleman. I wonder if EA Sports will put in any of the celebrations from this season and the next year's game. Behind the seats, they look like gooses, the leapfrog or whatever. Very creative, I have to say. However, if anybody watched the Thursday night game between the Steelers and Titans, you'll saw that, I don't remember his name, one of the Titans dropped a wide open pass, and one tends to wonder if it didn't have anything to do with him thinking about his celebration. Starter back to pass. Trailing. Finds Boyd Deller. Give to Horning, and Horning is going to carry Grady Jarrett for the first down. Time Horning ran into a wall of Falcons. Star's gonna be in the shotgun. He's got three receivers to the left. Packers trailing the Falcons 21-24. Boyd Dowler makes a move and he's still going. Boyd Dowler's fourth reception with 33 yards and a touch. He's finally pushed out of bounds. Lombardi. It's like saying that name. Lombardi. Starting shotgun. Horning on a carry. And the Golden Boy is going to pick up 6 yards. He's over 100 yards rushing for the season. 40 on the day. And that is the end of the third quarter with Atlanta leading Green Bay 24-21. I'd like to welcome in my viewer, whoever you are. I think it's my brother. Not sure. McGee goes in motion. And a flag down.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
It wasn't on the tackle. They're calling it on, looked like on the tackle. I didn't see it, but. Green Bay moves the sticks. Gary Neifeld got the reception. Of course, he got the touchdown last week against Seattle. To get to 1-0. Actually, I think it was Willie Wood blocking the field that really got him to 1-0. Horning up the middle. You can hear Lombardi now. Grab, grab, grab. I guess that'd be on defense. Star goes down as put Grady Jarrett's in there. Not Grady Jarrett. Tack McKinley. Gets in to get the sack. The rookie. Touchdown to Kramer. Kramer, 88 Kramer. Who's Kramer in 1960? It is. As I load my phone up. No, it's not Jerry. He's 64. Kramer, Kramer. Ron Kramer. 25-year-old out of Michigan. And the Packers have taken a lead. Oh, man. Just got a Facebook notification that somebody's in a ditch looking for a tow from Cape Vincent. If you run a tow truck company in upstate New York today, I bet you're getting some business. For amazing neighbors. Snow pictures. Yeah, it's a snowy Sunday, that's for sure. Matt Ryan throwing across the middle, incomplete. Matt Ryan, 10 of 17, 147 yards on the touchdown as they're taking on the monstrous Green Bay Packers. Sunday Night Football, week 2 of our Connected franchise. Bills getting a win over Carolina. As Wilmer Fowler busted out again. Another big day. Giants have yet to play. And again, as we said, there's issues concerning their record. You can physically see they won week 1, but didn't record it. When I simmed it, it said they won again. And now it's showing that they're 0-1. I don't know. And of course, the Steelers games, the only time you'll see it broadcast is when they play one of us, and they don't in year one. It's not really, it's almost intercepted. Right in the hands of 65. Tom Bettis, a 65. I'm going to play late, but I look it up on my phone each time I have to load the roster and alphabetize it if I'm looking for the name. not alphabetical. Numericalize it. It starts out in alphabetical order. But if you don't know the name, it's easier to look up by number. And Tom Bettis isn't one of the names you hear about when you think of 1960s Packers. Oh, Matt Ryan overthrowing his intended receiver. Ray Nitschke on the coverage. Think about his famous NFL Films line. That'll cool your ass off. Falcons are going to punt. That could be it for them. The Packers go into their ball control offense, which they're not known to do in video games, but going to be out of bounds. Matt Bosher all of a sudden's got a strut on him after that punt. That was a good punt. Bart Starr, 12 of 18, 163 yards. He does not have four touchdowns. I don't understand why they're giving him credit for the kick return by Paul Hornung. He has three touchdowns. Starr steps up. Past Jerry Kramer. Still got time. Throws. All that for nothing. Video games sometimes can be frustrating when stuff like that happens. Has all kinds of time to throw for covered receiver. You think somebody would come up and break their route off or something to come back. Man, look at that. The Packers have thrown 19 passes. That's unlike a Lombardi team to throw more than they run. But you can't, like I said, you can't get everything perfect in these. You get the rosters looking right. You gotta play by 2017 rules. Gary Neifeld? No. Number 80. Steve Meilinger on reception. Meilinger coming across the field. Brings up the first down. I'm begging you, Green Bay, run Paul Hornung. Run a Packer sweep. It's you, Lombardi. I'm telling you, run a sweep. Tackle. Right up the gut for Hornung. Makes a man miss, and he's gone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Let's see if they give that one credit to start, too. Nice little move. Little cut there, and Hornung is gone. The Notre Dame. The Golden Domer. The Golden Boy. Paul Hornung. The Hall of Famer. And now Hornung to kick the extra point as he switches his jersey number from 5 to 1 real quick. Again, if you're just joining us, you can't make position players kickers. So I have to create the guy twice and therefore give him a different number. What's really going to be interesting as we get further into this thing is if the player is no longer on the team. Let's say Paul Hornung. Okay? He retired after Super Bowl I. Well, let's say we get through the 66 season and he's still going. and then I have to go cut him. And in a blasphemous move, the Bears pick him up, or the even worse, a team like the Ravens that don't exist yet. It's going to be weird seeing these players end up on other teams. Especially the two accidental teams where I... Here's the story. I accidentally saved, when I first started the editing, I'd gotten through about 25 names or so on each team. And then I was working on the 73 alternate Super Bowl rosters, the Raiders and Cowboys, and I accidentally saved them at... The Cowboys were done and the Raiders were 50% done over the top of the 60 roster. So I had to restart the whole 60 roster. Well, instead of starting from scratch, I was a little lazy. So there's a good portion of the Cowboys that are 73 and the Raiders half of them 73. Now, of course, the computer's controlling those teams, so there's going to be trades and cuts and stuff that you won't see. If you go and you watch John M's broadcast of his week one game against the Giants and Cowboys, which evidently didn't count for some reason, but you'll see it's the 1960 New York Giants, Frank Gifford, Charlie Connolly, Sam Huff against the 1973 Dallas Cowboys, and Roger Staubach and Bob Lilly and all that. Casual look from Lombardi. Packers exploding in the fourth quarter for two touchdowns. 2 minutes to go. Again, at the conclusion of Sunday Night Football tonight between the Cowboys and Eagles, join Vinny X Wolf Channel as we redo, try and change history with a game of the week voted on by my followers. Currently leading the voting is the Monday night game between the Cowboys and Giants from week one in 1986, the game in which the Cowboys won 31-24. So as of now, voting will go on until 8 p.m. Eastern in about 12 hours. As of now, I'll be controlling the Giants and trying to get them a victory, which, you know, they already had 14 in 86. Coach happened. Ryan in the shotgun. Next Sunday, the alternate Super Bowl, Super Bowl 9 between the Rams and Raiders. Due to the fact that I'm working next Sunday, I know I don't seem to work many Sundays, but I do. The game will be done early. I'm thinking around midnight Eastern time. But it'll be there in the archives for you to go back and watch when you're awake. Rams and Raiders, Super Bowl 9. Alternate Super Bowl 9. I was watching real Super Bowl 9 last night, and I got through the first half. What a weird game. What a great defensive game. The Steelers lead at halftime 2-0 over the Vikings. Somebody put a block on there that absolutely turned, I believe, Ray Nitschke upside down and inside out. I'm not going to see the highlights because it's just a running or incomplete play, but wow. All right, so the Falcons down by 11. They need two scores. They're going to go for the field goal first. There's Matt Bryant to kick a 34-yarder. And it's good. Now they're down by 8. They've got to get the ball back. They do have all three timeouts. So they either go for the onside kick or they go for the defense and try and stop the Packers from picking up the first down. Or both. Both is probably the better answer. Well, here comes the onside kick. And it is going to be recovered. By Jim Quinlan. Actually, that was like 86. I think it was Boyd Dowler. I was thinking 68. Floyd Dowler on the recovery. And the snow that's already piling up on out there. And it's supposed to be 50 in 2 days. November for you. All right, so the Falcons have to stop the Packers without getting a first down and use all three of their timeouts. But again, they're being controlled by the computer, so who knows what's going to happen. Inexplicably running the ball sometimes, computer. Well, there's the first one, and they do call timeout. Devondre Campbell on the tackle. Well, had a beast of a game last week against the Cowboys with 6 sacks. Devontae Campbell. Devondre, I don't know. I apologize for getting the name wrong. Timeout again. Once again, the Packers run horny. Big play here, 3rd and 8. Nice to see a simulation game get some high scores. Horning is going to go up the middle, but he is not going to get anything. You see, that one I'm surprised at. I thought you'd throw the ball, knowing that they're going to call timeout, so running the ball to keep the clock moving doesn't really matter. Now, Atlanta's got no timeouts. Green Bay will go for the, oh, they're going for the 56-yard field goal out of Paul Horning. Which could pretty much ice the game. Kick is up, it is long enough, and it is no good, wide right. So the Falcons get the ball at the 46, no timeouts, down by 8. As Lamar McCann put the hold down, and Horning had the kick up, but it just goes, oh, under the crossbar, didn't have the distance. Well, Well, nobody was kicking 50-some-odd-yard field goals in the 1950s, 60s, 50s, so. They were pretty much all position players. Paul Horning being a running back. Matt Ryan in the shotgun. The Packers got the win in week one by blocking the field goal on the last play of the game. Ryan clocks the ball. Thrown incomplete. Intended for the tight end. The Falcons have thrown 30 passes and only run the ball 10 times. That's offense in today's game, though. High snap, handoff to Freeman, and it's going to be a fourth down. 4th and 11. Time is ticking. Ryan, all the time in the world, is going to throw. It's going to be long. It's caught. Jump ball, and Julio Jones comes down with it. Now the big question is the 2-point conversion. Men come to cover, she's not even looking at the ball. So it was a one-man jump. Going for two. Ryan's gonna run it. Oh, and he's gonna be brought down by Willie Davis, and it looks like Henry Jordan. What a play. Now the Falcons are going to have to go for the onside kick again. And this time they have to recover. If Green Bay recovers, game's over. Matt Ryan looked to be a planned quarterback draw, and Greminger comes in there at the end. He could have got a penalty. As Davis and Jordan bring him down, and Greminger comes in spearheading. Once again, right to Boyd Dowler, and that's the game, folks. Green Bay gets the 2-0. No, that's not Boyd Dowler. That's 88. That's, we looked it up earlier. That's Ron Kramer. Green Bay gets the 2-0. Victory formation for Bart Starr. I thank you for watching. Again, if you enjoyed these rosters and you have a PlayStation 4, you can download them on the PlayStation 4, 1960 or Vinnie X Wolf. The keyword search. 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. Green Bay goes into Atlanta, gets the win. They're 2-0. They beat Seattle on a blocked field goal on the last play. And with 27 seconds to go, they stop the Falcons on a two-point conversion attempt. The 2-0. What a game, though. I'd like to see one of these alternate Super Bowls get a sim like that. That was a hell of a game. Both teams get decent rushing yards, so just... You can join us tonight for the 86 redo, and we'll see you later.